Hello there, everybody. I'm Dr. Williams, and welcome to my Q&A session. Our topic today is the thymus gland and how it protects us from infections. Very important in the time of the COVID illness, and one of the most overlooked concerns on how to protect yourself not only from viruses, but also from cancer and other diseases. So your immune system is involved in stages of infection, and the thymus develops the frontline fighters called the T cells, and they're a type of lymphocyte, and there's really two main types. There's a helper type and a cytotoxic type, but it gets super complicated after that. But essentially, what happens is that you have a stem cell that's produced in your bone marrow, and that goes into your bloodstream, finds its way to the thymus gland. The thymus gland is right here, right behind your breastbone, just on top of your heart. And it's a small gland, but it does a tremendous amount of work. What's very interesting is that we have a good-sized thymus gland, a very active thymus gland when we're young, up until we're about 19 years old. And then it starts to atrophy and progressively get smaller and smaller, probably just getting tired with over time. And by the time we're my age, for example, then we have more incidence of cancer. We're more susceptible to infections of all types, and as well as COVID-19. So we want to keep our thymus strong, and hardly anybody's talking about that. So I'd like to talk to you a little bit about that today, and also answer questions that you might have. So I'd like to see if you have any questions, and we'll start with that, and then we'll start from there. So remember, you know, there's only one way not to get sick, and that's not to get the condition, and if it's an infection, not to get infected, and you get infected when you're exposed. So that's the only way that you're not going to get sick. But if you get exposed to a viral infection like the coronavirus, then a robust immune response works to tame or eliminate or, you know, completely get rid of that virus. And there's two parts. There's the antibody part, which you hear a lot about in the testing for the antibodies, and then you hear about the testing where they find out if the virus is shedding when they're doing the swab testing. That's a PCR test that puts you right where that virus is, and into your system, into your nasal passages and your throat, and also the gut as well. And that can be picked up in saliva and stool and urine. And that tells us if there's active virus going on in your body. So, but before that is exposure, and then after that is the antibodies. So here we have some questions coming in. One is there an acupuncture treatment for improving immunity? Absolutely. So I learned this decades ago. I'm originally from San Diego, and I live in Sarasota, Florida now. And so I had a patient come in and was telling me, I'm always getting sick. I can catch everything that goes along. And I have some patients here in Sarasota like that. And said, acupuncture has helped me in the past. And I said, okay, let's start with the acupuncture. And I didn't expect that much. I thought we need to take zinc, we need to take vitamin C, we need astragalus, we need compounds, and we need medications, we need natural drugs. And sure enough, that patient had no infections that year, no cold or flu, and as long as they had monthly acupuncture. So absolutely, acupuncture works. And we know a little bit about how it works. It does work on the T cells, and we also treat in the area of the thymus. So I believe that it's a, you know, a thymus associated effect from the acupuncture, and definitely works. Any other questions related to treatments, I think is important. And you'll find that those patients that get acupuncture, they maintain the effect for weeks or months afterwards. If they have regular treatment, approximately once a month, then they very rarely catch cold or flu during the season. And if they skip a month, they seem to do okay. They start to skip 2 to 3 months or so, then we have then you can start to see little by little their tendency to get infected comes back. The number one way to keep your immune system strong is to make sure you get enough zinc. And when the coronavirus epidemic started and the pandemic went ballistic, you couldn't buy zinc anywhere. Costco was sold out. All the drugstores were sold out. All the health food stores were sold out. All the suppliers were sold out. And the manufacturers were sold out. So we have now zinc back in, and I like to use zinc as a starting point. You have to have enough zinc. Most healthy people are get enough zinc. If they take a multivitamin, you get enough. But to improve your thymus, you need at least 15 milligrams, not one or two, and sometimes up to 30, sometimes 60. Or 90 milligrams of zinc, and I recommend zinc picolinate. That would be a maximum dose would be 30 milligrams three times a day during the flu or coronavirus season, and 15 milligrams a day to 30 milligrams a day once a day for the rest of the year. Now, you add to that selenium, vitamin A, C, and vitamin D3. You read a lot about vitamin D3 and the coronavirus, and people have low normal vitamin D levels. So that's very, very strange, because especially in Southern California and Florida, because we think that the sun is what makes the vitamin D, but in fact, and I did a study on this, we did research when I was teaching clinical nutrition at the University of Humanistic Studies, and the vitamin D levels were low on surfers, on golfers, and then we looked at South Africa and Australia and India, and everybody was finding the same thing. There's more to vitamin D than the sun. And you want to keep your vitamin D level, when you do it on a blood test and the range is up to about 100, you want to keep that strong, 70 to 90, even 100, 110. And it requires at least 10,000 to 25,000 units of vitamin D3 a day. If you're going to take that much, you need a little bit extra vitamin K, and often you'll see them come together in one capsule. And sometimes if patients are really deficient, then in the clinic we do vitamin D3 injections for them. It gets it up very, very fast. And you should definitely check your vitamin D25 hydroxy level. Check your zinc level in your blood. Check your selenium level in your blood. And boost the vitamin A. And remember, that's going to be the fish oil A, and you want to take 5 to 10,000 of that. The other compound that's really interesting is the astragalus. And there's a special form of astragalus. Now, everybody knows huangqi astragalus. So huang means yellow. It's kind of a light, whitish yellow color. And qi is the type of common a tonification root in used in Chinese medicine. So there are many different types of that. But the huangqi is very common and used in all types of formulas to rebuild the system. Now, the type that helps the thymus, though, is very specific, and it's not just an extract of astragalus, but it's a compound called astragalide 4. And you can get that through my website, and you want to take 25 to 100 milligrams a day. It's also useful for anti-aging and for, as I mentioned, thymus and in the treatment of cancer. So if you want to discover what's going on with your T cells and you want to get that measured, and I like to use LabCorp's helper suppressor and natural killer cell profile. And if you want us to order that for you, just contact my office or contact me by email. And we didn't get a lot of questions today, but next time I'm going to be waiting for you to ask me all kinds of questions that you find that you haven't been getting answers on. That's why I'm here, with almost 40 years of clinical experience, over 150,000 patient visits. For more information, check out my website, drjewilliams.com. Find my books, Viral Immunity, published in 2002 when the first SARS came out, and Beating the Flu a few years later on pandemic influenza. And follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and LinkedIn. And for long reads, for more serious reading, find me on Medium. I just put out an interesting article on uncertainty related to the coronavirus and why we have a hard time managing uncertainty as human beings. Okay, take care. Good to talk to you. And yes, there'll be a transcript and a video. Thank you.